The Lusca St Phenomena. We know more about the surface of the moon than we do about the bottom of our deepest oceans, so the old saying goes. It is an adage that, over time, is proving more and more relevant. What creatures actually do lurk at the bottom of the sea? Around the Bahamas and the Southeast American coast there are tales of a giant octopus that captures unwary swimmers and small boats. The people of the islands call it the Lusca and believe it lives in deep underwater caves. However, no one has ever seen the creature in its natural environment and lived to tell the tale. One evening in November 1896, two men were cycling along the coast just outside their hometown of St. Augustine, Florida. As they looked over the beach, they noticed a huge carcass. It was 23 feet long, 18 feet wide, 4 feet high, and it seemed to have multiple legs. The two men decided to tell Dr. DeWitt Webb, the founder of the St. Augustine Historical Society and Institute of Science, who came to examine the corpse. Webb photographed the body, noting it was a silvery pink color, and took samples. Webb recorded that the skin was axe-proof, being 3.5 inches thick. He also estimated that the body weighed around 6 or 7 tons. It needed 4 horses and a whole team of people from the local community to drag it the painstaking 40 feet up the beach in order to keep it away from the rolling waves. Webb was convinced it was not part of a whale, and must have been some kind of unknown giant octopus, so he sent letters describing the carcass to many eminent scientists. One such expert was Professor Verrill at the National Museum, now called the Smithsonian in Washington, D.C. Verrill stated that the creature was actually a squid. When Webb sent him more information, he changed his mind and said it was an octopus. Verrill suggested it probably had tentacles around 100 feet long. Verrill refused to see the dead creature in person, or indeed to provide any funds or resources to help preserve the sea monster. Even so, the professor decided this new species should be named after himself, calling it Octopus giganteus Verrill. Finally, he changed his mind again after receiving tissue samples, and said the body was probably just the head of a sperm whale. Webb was disappointed and preserved as many samples of the creature as he could. Eventually the corpse was retaken by the sea. Over 50 years later, two marine biologists, Dr. F. G. Wood and Dr. J. F. Gennaro Jr., discovered stories of the St. Augustine sea monster in old newspaper clippings. They applied to the Smithsonian and took samples from the original specimens Webb had sent Verrill. Wood had worked in the Bahamas and knew of the famous Lusca. The legend said that it was a giant octopus, with arms 75 feet long, that lived in great deep blue holes in the sea floor. By looking at the samples, Wood and Gennaro were able to deduce that the body was indeed that of an enormous octopus. At long last, Webb had been proved right. In recent years, other examples of huge, previously unknown, sea creatures have been discovered. Tales of giant squid have been told through the ages, but it is only in the last century that accurate and scientific details have been truly kept. Even in this day and age, some bizarre stories still have cropped up. French fishermen have recently been attacked by one multi-legged sea creature, and marine biologists are constantly finding remains of squid which outsize the previously known largest. At the moment, the biggest giant squid find happened in April 2003 when a colossal squid was found in Antarctic waters. The example found was still immature, but had an overall length of around 50 feet. Octopi, by comparison, are small fry, and the biggest, caught in March 2002, only measured 13 feet. So the beast at St. Augustine is still a truly unexplained phenomenon.